Hello, true crimers of YouTube and Instagram. This is the confounding disappearance of Garrett Bardsley. On August 20th, 2004, around 8 o'clock in the morning, 12-year-old Garrett, along with his father, Kevin, they were on a Boy Scouts trip with a bunch of other Boy Scouts and other adults that were there supervising. Well, the father and son, they got up early to go fishing. Now, this was at Kuberant Lake, which is located in Summit County, Utah. Garrett and his dad were actually from Elk Ridge in Utah. So while the father and son were out there fishing, Garrett managed to get himself soaking wet. So he told his dad, I'm gonna go back up to the camp real quick and just get into a new change of clothes. Now, the campsite where the Boy Scouts were was literally 200, 250 feet away from where they were fishing. You know, it was kind of up a hill, up a little path. Kevin was able to still see Garrett walking, and he was even shouting directions to him. On this trip, Kevin and Garrett walked this trail many times, so Kevin was comfortable letting Garrett go on his own. This is a trip that should have literally taken maybe a minute, 2 minutes. 20 minutes later, Kevin notices Garrett hasn't come back. When Kevin got back to the campsite trying to find Garrett, he realized that Garrett was gone. Not only was he gone, but no one said he even got to the campsite. No one saw him go there. Garrett was wearing a black hoodie and reversible black and red sweatpants. He was also carrying his fishing pole, and he was carrying nothing else. No food, no supplies, nothing. The search for Garrett immediately began. They had hundreds of people combing the entire area looking for him. At one point, on a little area full of rocks and boulders, they found one of Garrett's white Nike socks, but no other sign of Garrett, and also his fishing pole wasn't there either. They searched the area by helicopter, by foot, with horses. They brought in search dogs. The sock was found roughly half a mile away from where he was last seen. Basing where they found the sock, they said maybe Garrett was trying to take some sort of shelter from the weather. After 9 days, the search for Garrett ended. But Garrett's parents, both pictured here, they along with a whole bunch of family and friends would continue searching for Garrett, but they never found anything. They've gone back year after year looking, but nothing. They've never given up hope, but it's possible he could have been attacked by a grizzly bear or a mountain lion, but no one heard any screams or anything. There was no blood found, no bones. Could he have been quietly kidnapped? No one knows.